MDMA, also known as ecstasy or Molly, is the psychedelic that's the closest to getting FDA approval for treatment for PTSD. But what is MDMA and what does it do? That's what I'm talking about today. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Psychedelics are the wave of the future in psychiatry. I've talked about psilocybin, aptly called magic mushrooms, because what they do for depression is magical compared to how traditional antidepressants work. You can take a look at this video for more on mushrooms, and I'll have the video linked at the end of this one. MDMA is equally as powerful, especially for treating post-traumatic stress disorder, also called PTSD. The chemical name for MDMA is 3,4-methylenedioxymethamphetamine. So yes, it's a stimulant similar to Adderall and methamphetamine. But MDMA has hallucinogenic properties, whereas Adderall does not. Or it's not supposed to. MDMA alters how you process emotions. When you bring to mind a negative experience, the MDMA says, hold on, not so fast, let's pause a minute to process this. It helps you better experience positive emotions like feeling safe or feeling more in control. You can also better appreciate that what happened was then and this is now. It's common for you to have uncomfortable physical sensations when you have your negative recall. The MDMA opens your mind to experience the physical sensations differently and not see them as threatening. How does it do this? MDMA reduces your fear response that's activated in your amygdala. Another thing that MDMA does is promote acceptance and empathy for yourself and others. Often people who have experienced chronic trauma or early childhood trauma can develop a thinking style of self-blame, not just for what happened in the past, but for current situations. There's a lot of self-loathing. And MDMA-assisted therapy can help expand your awareness of your personal assets, like you're giving yourself a new valuation. And this valuation is based on fresh, objective information that is applied with self-compassion. The chemical changes that occur in your brain are getting elevated levels of oxytocin, which you can think of as an attachment or bonding hormone. And you get increases in serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. The decrease in amygdala activation allows people to be less afraid of working through therapy without becoming emotionally overwhelmed. This all sounds really good, so how is this going to happen? The Multidisciplinary Association for Psychedelic Studies has been studying MDMA for 20 years. They were initially granted FDA approval to research it in 2001. It took time to raise money for research, and in 2020, they completed their phase 3 clinical trial for using MDMA-assisted psychotherapy for PTSD. Phase 3 is the last testing phase before the company submits an application to the FDA for approval. I've seen estimates that they plan to submit the application in 2023. What did the study look like? In the study, participants took a dose of MDMA and stayed overnight to be observed. Then they had 3 90-minute therapy sessions separated by days. They repeated that cycle twice for a total of 3 doses of MDMA and 9 follow-up therapy sessions. The results of the study were remarkable. 2/3 of the participants who took MDMA no longer met the criteria for PTSD. And these were people who were considered treatment resistant with PTSD for an average of 14 years. That's pretty impressive given that PTSD responds best when it's fresh. It's harder to treat, but still possible to treat, but harder to treat when you suffer with it for many years. Many of the participants also had depression with their PTSD, and their depression also improved. One of the very troubling symptoms of PTSD is reliving the traumatic experience or being unable to control the memories intruding into your thoughts, even when you're not intentionally thinking about them. Part of the usual coping process is to avoid thinking about what happened. But with trauma memories, suppressing the thoughts or running away from them doesn't make them go away. So as effective as trauma therapy is, many people will not want to do it because they don't want to deal with the upsetting experience of having to rehash what happened or even being reminded of things that they worked hard to forget. This is where MDMA-assisted therapy can come to the rescue and help facilitate proper emotional processing of the traumatic experience in a way that you can tolerate revisiting it and have your brain reprocess it so it's no longer traumatic for you. So now we have to wait until this drug is approved. Why not just use what's already available on the street? Well, first of all, it's illegal. But even if you get your hands on it, there's a good chance that what you take is cut with another agent and is not 100% MDMA. You don't have to believe me. You can take a look at the site drugsdata.org. I'll have it linked in the description. This site publishes laboratory-tested samples from various sources. It gives you a picture of the pill and where it came from. It also gives you a breakdown of what agents were found in the sample. If we take a quick peek, you can see data from 2022. Out of the 2,400 samples, only 554 were exclusively MDMA. 106 of the samples had no MDMA, and even though it was sold as MDMA. And this bottom category is pills that were sold as something else but really contained MDMA. If you drill down on some of the lists, you can see that common agents used to mix with the ecstasy are caffeine, cocaine and other stimulants, and ketamine. So using street ecstasy doesn't produce the same controlled experience you get with prescription MDMA given in conjunction with psychotherapy. Even if you take the good stuff, the drug makes the chemical changes that opens your mind, but you still need guidance with how to use that open mind to change ingrained patterns of thinking. So just taking MDMA alone doesn't produce the same results. We still don't know what this approval, when it comes, will look like since the study was based on taking the drug along with getting manualized therapy. I suspect that the rules around it will be similar to ketamine, where the clinician has to get certified to deliver the treatment and show that they have training to deliver the therapy or have someone in-house to do the therapy. I guess that may be what's taking a while to get the approval. But either way, it's exciting to have another novel drug available. Also, the acceptance of another psychedelic opens the door to more to be used therapeutically. For more on psilocybin, take a look at this video. I'm researching doing another mushroom video based on an article I read about mushrooms possibly being able to reverse personality disorders. That's huge. Personality disorders have always been something that is seen as only slightly to moderately changeable with tons of therapy. To have a drug that can erase all the bad stuff and help us all get along, that's like multiverse stuff. But I'm looking into it. Stay tuned. See you next time.